Hello everyone, welcome to the bronze medal match at the 2012 Olympic Games men's water polo competition. It are two countries who were joined at the hip not too many years ago. Serbia and Montenegro will dispute the match. It's a repeat of the bronze medal game of 4 years ago when Serbia won by 6-4. Montenegro finished second in Group B, beating Spain 11-9 in the quarterfinals and then lost to Croatia in the semis. Serbia managed to finish first in Group B. They beat Australia 11-8 in the quarterfinals and lost to Italy 9-7 in the semis. So two more matches left. The bronze medal match, Montenegro against Serbia. Not too many years ago, they were competing as one country. And in the gold medal match still to come, it's Croatia against Italy. Let's look at the respective records now of the two countries here at London 2012. Serbia with 5 wins and just 1 defeat. Montenegro not too far behind them. Serbia beat Montenegro 6-4 in that bronze medal match then in Beijing 2008. 7 members of the current Serbian team played in that game 4 years ago. So let's meet the two teams. Montenegro side, Paskovic at his first Olympic Games. Here's Petrovic, the right-hander. Vaskovic, who plays in Italy. Radovic, who actually plays in Serbia. This is the Montenegro side, hoping to take bronze here. Nikola Janovic, he has had his shoulder injury problems in the last year. Slokovic, former Yugoslav international. Gojkovic, who has played for Serbia and Montenegro when they competed together. This is Jokic. Silver medal for Serbia and Montenegro in Athens 8 years ago. And here's the second goalkeeper, part of a UNICEF campaign. So check on the Serbian side. This is Soro, 6'6" tall goalkeeper. Gocic, a bronze medalist 4 years ago. Budovicic, 14 goals in the tournament so far for him. Dusan Mandic, one of the babies of the squad, just 18 years old. Pietlovic, whose older brother Gojko, also in this squad, we'll see him later. Nikic, silver medalist at Athens in 2004, plays in Italy. This is Aleksic at his first Olympic Games. Radin, bronze in Beijing 4 years ago. Filipovic with 14 goals so far in the tournament. Here's the big goal scorer, 21 goals so far. I'm sure he'll be adding to that total. Mitrovic, first Olympic Games. Vuko Pietovic, the goalkeeper, although Soro is the first choice. So here are two referees, one from Greece, one from Italy. Joining me in the commentary position is fellow water polo commentator Tony Jones. Tony, is he money on for this bronze medal match? Is it going to be the same as 4 years ago?
there was nothing between them in Group B when it finished 11-all, and it was Montenegro scored twice late on after trailing 11-9 with goals from Ivovic and Janovic. Serbia, they were the European champions back in January. They defeated Montenegro then 9-8. So when you look at the respective records of the two countries who feature in this bronze medal fixture, there is really nothing between them. It's a difficult one to call.
And an added dimension to this match is that they were competing together 8 years ago.
Very true, yes, before the independence, which came in 2008, when Montenegro split away from Serbia.
So you have players like the Montenegrin goalkeeper Sefic, number one there, who won a silver in Athens for Serbia and Montenegro. Similar story for number 11, Gojkovic, who has retired from international water polo only to return again. Here are the results for Montenegro and the standout result, that 11-all draw against Serbia in the group stage. I wonder if it's going to be equally tight in this game.
And also it came on the back of their success over Hungary. Hungary came into the Olympic Games on the back of 17 wins, but they lost their opening two fixtures. There was a classic case of a team getting old at exactly the same time. You look at Montenegro and you look at Serbia, these are teams who could be around for another 5 or 10 years.
Ranko Petrovic, the coach. Really, the former Yugoslav nations have really dominated the semi-finals of this competition, haven't they, Tony?
They have, but they haven't been able to produce a gold medal as yet. But Serbia certainly will, I'm sure, now settle for bronze against Montenegro, having lost out to Italy, who will contest the final against Croatia later.
Milanovic on 21 goals. He was number 11. Serbia's results here. Just one defeat, that narrow defeat which came against Italy in the semi-finals.
And starting with that 14-10 win over Hungary.
The coach burns off a short fuse. He's been shown a couple of yellow cards in the matches I've commentated on. On this last day of the Olympic Games, London 2012, who's going to take the bronze here? Serbia in the blue hats against Montenegro. Montenegro and Serbia actually separated in 2006. And until that date, they formed one team. Denis Sefic, Montenegro. Vladimir Gojkovic of Montenegro. Jokic of Montenegro. And Vučić of Serbia and Nikic of Serbia played together for Serbia and Montenegro in the Athens 2004 Olympic Games. Sefic actually played for Serbia at the 2008 Olympics before switching nationalities and joining Montenegro in 2010.
Sefic hasn't been the first pick for Montenegro in a couple of their games. It's Sepanovic from Jada who has been given the starting berth, wearing the number 13 cap.
I just wonder if they trust him against some of his former pals.
Well, he has got experience, and I think that is always useful to have when you've got the likes of Saponic, the 20-year-old, the newcomer to the squad, coming through now. So it's a nice balance for Serbia and for Montenegro as well. You've got the likes of Draskovic, who's one of those playing in Italy. Of course, there's such a big professional league in Italy. That is where these players have benefited on the big stage. So we're all ready for the first sprint of this bronze medal fixture.
Looks like it's going to be Paskovic who will dispute the swim-off for Montenegro. The third and fourth place game is underway. It's the former brothers-in-arms, Montenegro against Serbia, and Serbia win the swim-off quite decisively. And they're on the attack. Good sprint there by Filipovic. Remember, seven in the pool per team. Unless there is an exclusion for an exclusion foul. That means 20 seconds out the pool. Six here is Pietlovic. Ball dropped over the top and plenty of white water there. It's going to be that sort of game. There's plenty of pushing and shoving going on.
Filipovic could be the key for Serbia. Dominant figure who won a bronze 4 years ago. Another of those who's playing professionally at the moment in Italy. But look out for him. Number 10 for Serbia.
And there's an exclusion foul here against Udovicic. So power play in favour of Montenegro. They have the extra player in the pool up to the 5 metre line. And they have the opening goal. Lovely tip in there. Zlokovic, former Yugoslav international, makes it 1-0.
See there the exclusion. With the arm on the shoulder of Boris Zlokovic initially, and then the ball sent forward by Mladen Janovic, one of the two brothers, Mladen and Nikola. Mladen Janovic, who's got that role in the centre just behind the goal scorer there.
So that lovely tip in by Zlokovic gives us the opening score of the game. I wonder if we're going to have such a high scoring game as we had in the group stage. They don't have Noor. Penalty foul. Chance immediately for Serbia to hit back here with Brelenovic. Can he score his 22nd goal of the London Olympic Games? Goalkeeper almost got there, not quite. Montenegro's lead did not last long. Foul here by Zlokovic under the goalkeeper's arm. 1-1.
Well executed penalty. Despite all their big game experience, you know full well when it comes to a medal game, the nerves will be jangling a little bit early on. We're in this first quarter, they're still testing each other out in some ways, but you can see the anxiety is an opportunity for Serbia to get in and to make a challenge.
Remember, Serbia, the bronze medal holders from 4 years ago, anything less would be seen as a disappointment for them. Bronze medal match 4 years ago against Montenegro. So Montenegro press forward again up to the towards the 5 metre line. That's a good steal. Nothing wrong with that, despite the look by Gojkovic. Here is Gocic. Serbia just getting into their stride. They've got the ball inside the 5 metre line. Turnover foul. Jepnovic was the guilty party, and a bit of a let off there for Montenegro, who now counter attack.
Physically, there's no doubt that Montenegro got the edge in the pool when you look at the height and weight of some of their players.
Serbian exclusion here. And it results in another power play. Guljan on target. Well, the goalkeeper got his hands to the ball but then couldn't claw it back out again. Second goal then to Montenegro.
Fabulous technique in the water, just getting out of the water as much as he possibly could. Tremendous effort and power in that effort from Bruglin.
I think it's relevant that both Montenegro goals have come from power plays.
It could prove significant later on, but you can see how the wrestling is going on in the edge of that 5 metre mark, and we've already seen a penalty foul. That's almost the decoy. Look at the centre forward, the player in the hole.
And he got away to scoot that shot into the goal. Nikic on target. Whatever Montenegro can do, Serbia can do in reply.
Bit of frustration really for Nikic. He didn't play in 2008. He won silver back in 2004, but maybe that shows that he wants this desperately now, given the opportunity. Just did too much for Petrovic, didn't he, when he pulled away from him.
Each time Montenegro have taken the lead, Serbia have come back quickly.
See Gojkovic there to the left of your picture in the centre position. Just trying to make things happen for the team with the white hats, Montenegro.
Into their driver position. Another Serbian exclusion here, and it's a number 8, Janovic. Rather the number 8 for Serbia, Aleksic, who disappears.
There's a double exclusion, so they're really up against it now here, Serbia.
Aleksic and Nikic out the pool. One's back though. They need to get this shot away, and when they do, the skip shot bounces harmlessly over. Bourrienne well off target, and that really, bearing in mind there was a two-player advantage, was an opportunity miss for Montenegro.
Well defended by Serbia, however.
Milenovic. More holding going on in the hole. Fantastic wrestling match. One of the referees haven't stopped it yet. In fact, they have now.
There's exclusion. Exclusion for Montenegro's Petrovic.
So, opportunity knocks here for Serbia. And they score. They had the extra player in the pool. And Mitrovic gives them the lead for the first time. Look at this.
Great finish by Mitrovic. Another one who missed out 4 years ago. He was injured in a motorcycling accident before the games in Beijing.
So Mitrovic at his first Olympic Games. 3:11 left of the first period. Narrowest of margins here for Serbia.
Draskovic has been expected to do a big job for Montenegro during the Olympics this time around, with Janko Petrovic, the coach, having taken over a couple of years back. There was a disappointing fifth place finish for Montenegro then. Decided to change things. The Red Sharks, as they're known, brought in Petrovic, who has enjoyed club success, having won a European title with Primorac of Koto.
Redden. They almost got a man in behind the Montenegrin defence. Didn't quite come off, and Petrovic almost through. For his 15th goal of the tournament.
It was Lokovic who was almost caught out. There was some clear water there for Udovicic to try and push on into.
Fine stop. Plenty of power in the effort. Strong hand there by the goalkeeper. Soro doing his job. Montenegro will try again. Udovicic.
see there how Serbia were trying to get two in the centre position. It was a fast swim out, and it's all a little bit disjointed at the moment from Serbia when they have the opportunity to get forward. Defensively, a little bit strong enough.
Montenegro looking for an exclusion foul, and their coach not too happy that there wasn't one. Meanwhile, Serbia have won possession back, and Saponjic races towards goal. Last 60 seconds of the first period. Very little to choose between these two countries.
That's a great steal. Run back by Gojkovic.
So time for one big attempt on goal here by Montenegro. Almost a steal there by Serbia. It is a steal. Decision goes away of the team with the blue caps. Montenegro not too happy about that. Stop the shot clock down at 16 seconds. So they'll run this to its natural conclusion before having a shot on goal. And try and open up a 4-2 lead by the end of the first period. They give it possession. Ambitious attempt. That's the end of the first period. Advantage narrowly. And I mean narrowly to Serbia. Not much in it at all. Montenegro having the lead twice in the first period. Serbia coming back twice and nicking the lead through Mitrovic. The end of the first quarter. Montenegro 2, Serbia 3. So we're just about ready and set for the second period of 8 minutes. Here's the swim off then at the start of the second period. Montenegro in the white swimming caps, remember. But it's Serbia who emerge with the ball. Next to the power in the water there of Saponjic, who actually plays in California in the USA.
He has a university there at the moment. He's 20, and him and Mandric, 18, are two of the new generation for Serbia. It's great that they can balance things out like that to introduce players of that age. It's quite a legacy to know that those who are in the cusp of the end of their careers at the moment can look forward to maybe helping one or two of the youngsters out. And it's the case as well with Montenegro. And look at the return of Sefic as goalkeepers, backup goalkeeper for them at the age of 35, still able to make a contribution, helping Petrovic, the coach, out.
Easy for Montenegro to draw level. Clenched fist there of Zlotkovic. that deficit early in the second period did not last long. Boris Zlotkovic has played for Yugoslavia. Makes it 3-3.
It's a great take. Did so well to get away from Prilanovic, who was trying to mark him, Andrea Prilanovic.
Two goals now in the match, 7 in total for the competition. An exclusion there. There is. It's the goal scorer Zlotkovic who's out of the water. Extra player here for Serbia. Chance to take the lead once again. Now there's an objection to that goal. Was there a foul before he tipped it in? The answer is yes, there was. It remains 3-3. That doesn't count. Nor does that. Montenegro claims the goalkeeper got a touch on the ball. Soro looks all confused as if to say, surely not me. The official outcome is no corner throw.
Seen a huge amount of so far in the water. Ivovic of Montenegro and Filipovic of Serbia. Two players who pre-match were singled out, marked out as the two who might have a great influence in deciding this bronze fixture.
Well, we didn't mind that challenge. And it is an exclusion foul. Radovic out of the pool. Well, the clumsy challenge.
Look at that curving space in the water just in front of Montenegro's goalkeeper, and it's worked.
Yeah, great goal by Gocic. They work the ball ever so well when they have the power plays.
And that's the moment when Radovic just slapped the face of Jugovic, and that's the goal. Great finish, fantastic finish there coming in from Gokic. Just see how he twists in the water and gets that extra momentum to beat Stepanovic.
So Serbia back in front at 4-3. Two sorts of foul in water polo, an ordinary foul. Well, the foul team just hang on to possession, and then an exclusion foul. And the fouling player has to leave the water for 20 seconds. Right here. Filipovic is out. Montenegro have the extra player.
Good work by Gojkovic and Zlotkovic in this centre area, just trying to make the openings, and you can see it work for Zlotkovic there as he set up that goal.
Ivovic makes it 4-4. Great purchase with a shot, a skip shot flying through the white water. Suddenly Montenegro are right back in it. Ivovic with his 13th goal of the tournament.
Ivovic got 3 when the teams drew in the group stages. Paired together in Group B, it finished 11-11 on that occasion.
Sloppy play by Serbia. Trying to keep the momentum of the attack going.
There's a rival battle going on in the centre there. Who's going to win this exchange? And who'd want to referee it? Well, they've got the exclusion that they were looking for there. Serbia with Bruglin out of the water for Montenegro.
So whilst Bruglin is out, Serbia failed to score. Montenegro nicked the ball back. Just a sense of ill luck there as the ball struck the frame of the goal, but it resolutely stayed out. Filipovic is already on two exclusion fouls, one more and he's out with a substitution. Montenegro counter-attack here and score. Been a while since they've had the lead. Janovic with an all-important goal for them.
Janovic, who was top scorer for Montenegro 4 years ago, he scored against Croatia in the bronze fixture on that occasion, and he's done so again. Tremendous finish.
Try telling Montenegro they're going to have to settle for fourth place again.
Sure, there's a concern that Filipovic of Serbia has got those two personal fouls against him. Now one more and he's out of the game altogether with a substitution. Not even at the halfway point. Markovic there, who's getting a firm hand on the shoulder of the centre-forward of Serbia. It's Nikic, I think, who was trying to muscle in and to find some space in the water.
Six here is Radovic. Can Montenegro press again and open up a two-goal advantage? Not like that. Accuracy of the shot, not quite good enough.
A little rotation from Montenegro when they get the ball in the centre, when they try to get onto the offence, and they've got Zlokovic and Gojkovic and now Jokic trying to make things happen and to work the ball into the wide areas. Who's going to take responsibility here? You can see just driving on, it's Jokic, the number 12.
Skip shot was of no great power, easily saved by Slobodan Soro. Next goal is going to be really important, and Serbia have possession. They get into their driver position, and that is a wayward shot. Stepanovic didn't have to make a save, the referee spotted something. Second exclusion foul against Gocic, and we've called a timeout as well. Timeout called by Montenegro.
Gocic out of the water for what happened after he tried to beat Stepanovic.
So with Gocic of Serbia still out of the water, Montenegro will have this advantage. A restart with Stepanovic getting things moving again.
Montenegro man up. We've seen Filipovic of Serbia get back into the pool.
Standing block.
So they have great technique as well from Montenegro as they try to work the opening.
That could be a crucial miss, you know, for Montenegro. They haven't managed to get two goals ahead at any stage of this game. And just before half time, that would have been a very useful lead indeed.
Still 90 seconds to go. There'll be more than one opportunity for both, you suspect.
Oh,
Well, he'd done the hard part, hadn't he, then, as Lokovic. Great chance.
Coach can't believe it.
Ball seemed to slip out of his hands, didn't it? He was there, he was set to shoot, but he couldn't oblige.
So as you were saying, Tony, Serbia have their chance before we get to the minute mark. Are they going to be as profligate in front of goal? They've drawn the exclusion foul against Janovic. They have the extra player. Do they have the goal? Oh. The angle was just too tight.
Done loads of work himself into that position. It's fine goalkeeping by Stepanovic. Mitrovic denied.
The team able to find the goal that would either bring Serbia level or give Montenegro a two-goal lead. Another big block. Advantage goes away on Montenegro, but there's only 27 seconds left now. Clock has been halted. We're off again.
You can see how their tactics are very different, where you've got Montenegro, somebody in the center, and two drivers close by with one in the hole. Whereas with Serbia, when they have the opportunity to attack, they tend to make the most of the wide areas. Oh, yellow card as well. Yellow card has been issued to the coach.
Once again. So three goals for Montenegro in that second period means the half-time score in this bronze medal match is Montenegro 5, Serbia 4. So the bronze medal match, delicately poised, with Montenegro leading Serbia by 5-4. As we head for the third quarter, 2 8-minute periods left. Sapolic will dispute the swim off. Alexander Radovic. Radovic, who plays in Serbia. Second half underway, we change ends. Serbia will win the swim off with some ease. Saponjic really did well there. Played at the World University Games in Shenzhen in China.
Her brother is also at the University of California. And Serbia, who have racked up the goals throughout this tournament, when you look back at their record, 14 against Hungary, 21 against Great Britain, possibly the weakest team. And then that 11-all draw against Montenegro. They were top scorers at that early stage of the competition. Milanovic with 15 in three. A lot of their goals coming from the centre, a lot of them coming from beyond the 5-metre mark.
It's the green line across the bottom of the pool. The ball is at the moment. Run back well here by Gocic. His international debut 11 years ago. He really has been around for some time, as have many of the Serbian team, playing against several of their former teammates when they competed as Serbia and Montenegro.
Serbia, the European champions, successful against Montenegro at the tournament held in the Netherlands back in January. Just missed out on the World Championships in China last year as well.
Interestingly, four European countries, Tony, disputing the last four places.
Yes, you would normally have expected the United States or maybe Australia to have sneaked in there somewhere. Yep. Serbia's build-up wasn't actually the best because head coach Udovicic was forced to play in a tournament in Italy with a much younger team than anticipated because of injuries to the likes of Jetlovic and Filipovic. A lob nearly crept in.
Wasn't too far away, little lob shot, didn't quite find its target. Zlotkovic already on two exclusion fouls. Two major fouls, so one more and he would miss the rest of the game, the rest of the tournament. Big save there, very big save by Stepanovic. And Montenegro. That really should have been a goal for Serbia to make it 5-5. And that's another big save. Paskovic going close. quality of goalkeeping in this level has been outstanding at times. Speed of the ball leaves the hand of the shooter.
Several players have had their throws, their shots measured, and 50 miles an hour is not unusual. So much strength needed to beat the water, to get the elevation and the lift out of the pool, to be able to deliver a shot with both power and accuracy. It's a big and heavy ball, don't forget that. Which is capped up again.
Yeah, the referees will allow the game to go on for some while the player's lost his cap, but eventually they do stop the game, so those caps can be replaced. Actually, the old caps are somewhere on the bottom of the pool at the moment.
Usually comes during a natural break like that. A free corner throw for Montenegro in the white.
Been a while since there's been a goal, Tony, isn't it? Right, we've got one now. As soon as I said that, I knew that was going to change, and Jokic now extends Montenegro's lead to 6-4. Yeah, that's could be significant. First time either of these two countries have had a two-goal advantage, and the tit-for-tat scoring of the first period seems to have stopped, or certainly slowed down. And I wonder now whether Montenegro can hold the advantage here after Jokic, who actually won silver for Serbia and Montenegro in Athens 8 years ago, scored that sixth Montenegrin goal. Exclusion foul here against Montenegro, so suddenly opportunity knocks here for Serbia. Radovic, that's Alexander, is out of the pool. 22nd exclusion foul. Serbia need to hurry up and get this shot away. Tip in virtually from underneath the crossbar is successful, and Pietlovic reduces the deficit.
It was neatly worked, very neatly worked goal by Serbia. Didn't have a great deal to aim at, but he knew exactly what he wanted to do.
So Dusko Pietlovic has a brother in the Serbian squad, who's the second goalkeeper. Filipovic out the pool. Again, just one goal in it.
That's the potential for overtime, 2-3 minute periods of overtime should they be level at the end of the fourth quarter, and beyond that a penalty shootout. Serbia successful in the penalty shootout in the world final against Spain in Rome back in 2009. They lost their world title to Italy in Shanghai again after extra time. Ivicic, the Serbian coach, paid Montenegro a tribute before the tournament began. He said that Montenegro and Hungary would be the two teams to present the biggest threat during the course of the London Games.
Alexander Radovic is out the pool. This is a great opportunity for Serbia to draw level. Long drive pass. And they've got it. They are level. That two-goal lead has disappeared. Montenegro pegged back. That's why there was the exclusion foul. And it's Radan who makes it 6-6.
Stepanovic will be disappointed that he didn't get anything on that shot. Might have seen it a little bit late, the goalkeeper, because there were a couple of white hats just in front of him as they tried to make the block, Montenegro. He made his international breakthrough back in 2008, the last Olympic year. Another exclusion.
Vukic is out again. Despite his protests, and it's going to be a penalty. Ivovic, chance to give Montenegro at least a one goal advantage, and he does just that.
There's always a bit of a balancing act for whoever takes the penalty shot to ensure that they stay on that 5 metre line. This is the incident which saw Gokic excluded, the number three there in the centre of your picture, tangling with Ivovic, who then, with the penalty shot, was able to score with some conviction. And Gokic now is out of the game altogether. That's an exclusion with a substitution. Three personal fouls against him. There you see it, major fouls. So he can take no further part in this bronze medal game. I think the realisation has just hit him.
So it's going to be a penalty foul here for Serbia. Chance to draw level once again. Powerfully put away, and whatever Montenegro can do, Serbia can do in response. Filipovic on target.
I was impressed by the left-hander after we saw Jokic excluded.
The rules clearly state that if you impede a player who's in the act of shooting, it's going to be a penalty. That's exactly what happened there. 7-7. You could easily see it being 11-11, couldn't you? But later stages, just as the two sides scrapped out an 11-11 draw at the group stage. Great opportunity here, yes, and it's Montenegro who have the lead here.
It was Radin who was given the 22nd exclusion then. You see the scramble going on in the centre of your picture, and a lapse of concentration which has presented Montenegro with the opportunity to take advantage through Jokic.
8-7 now. Three goals each in this third period.
It was two together, wasn't it? Radin and Aleksic, I think, has been excluded as a result. Either way, Jokic took that chance well.
Is that going to be a penalty? Certainly it's going to be an exclusion foul, no penalty, but an extra player here for Serbia to try and exploit. And they've done it. Every time Montenegro score, Serbia hit right back. Jetlevic on target. I think it might have been Udovicic who tipped it in.
Jetlevic it is, number six.
Jetlevic, the confirmation is Jetlevic. Scorer's not getting it quite right, but it definitely was Jetlevic. Being corrected.
One of the stars 4 years ago when he got 12 goals during the course of the tournament, Olympic tournament in Beijing. It's all a little bit stop-start this third quarter. Understand how the players are getting a little bit uneasy, a little bit tense and anxious, not wanting to make mistakes, not wanting to present the initiative to their opponents. What can Montenegro do here?
It could be a big miss, bearing in mind that they have the extra player. Jankovic going close. And there's a Serbian out of the pool now. It's Radovicic. Montenegro can press again. Whistle's gone. Is that a second Serbian out? I think it is.
And it's exclusion with a substitution as well. You can see the card being flourished there. There's a look of disbelief. It's Radin who has come out the water and has been shown the yellow card. It's exclusion with a substitution. Radin's out. That's two there minus now with Gokic also red carded. With Jokic anyway, he had those three fouls against his name. I wonder if Radin said something on the way out of the pool.
Meanwhile, Montenegro take full advantage of having two extra players and take the lead at 9-8 through Janovic. Great love lost between these two countries, is there?
Must keep an eye on number nine. It was Radin in the centre there. He is out of the game, and Janovic celebrates another goal. That's Nikola, the older of the two brothers. Effectively, two players down now, Serbia. Puts the pressure on those who remain in the pool and who were available to Radovicic, the coach, who's also been yellow carded, don't forget.
Montenegro have an exclusion foul. Petrovic. Chance comes and goes for Serbia. It's not been an easy quarter for them by any stretch of the imagination. Can Montenegro find a two-goal lead as we head for the final quarter? Oh dear. Going to be a penalty here for Montenegro. Nikola Janovic. Expertly executed. Janovic, who has had his shoulder injury problems, there's the pushing and shoving going on, which resulted in the penalty. Can't do that when the player's about to shoot, otherwise you'll give away a penalty just like that. Put the muscles on him.
Well, it was down to inexperience as much as anything by Stepanovic, who was guilty of that foul, that penalty foul, the 20-year-old. Imagine out of the water for Serbia, as is Gokic. Two players down. I forget that two of their squad of 13 are also goalkeepers.
Puts a lot of pressure on the players left, and Jokic excluded. Timeout called. Both teams now have taken one timeout each. So last few seconds of the third quarter. Oh, Montenegro going to find a way to the bronze medal, something they failed to do 4 years ago in Beijing. And Serbia prevailed. Will the extra man advantage they have in terms of the excluded players be crucial? Serbia going to have to take some of these opportunities when they come. That one just kept out. Tipped in against the crossbar and Montenegro survive. Two big chances for Serbia to reduce the deficit. Great save by the goalkeeper, touching it onto the crossbar. And they celebrate that save as if it were a goal. End of the third quarter, Montenegro 10, Serbia 8. Fourth and final quarter about to unfold here. Montenegro with the advantage. 10-8. Montenegro win the swim off. Can they take advantage of this early possession?
Montenegro now don't really have to take any chances, do they? They just need to keep possession. They can effectively run the clock down even in this early stage. And you could see then that there was just 6 seconds left to get that shot away. But while they've got possession, it makes it all the more difficult for Serbia to try and get back into the game.
Remember, Gokic and Radan out of the pool permanently here for this remainder of the game. Exclusion foul here called against Brilliant.
Good with the reaction of Sipanovic with every single save. Doesn't have to even be him, it can be a teammate, and he's still delighted.
They'll never have a better chance of meddling here, will they? Six is Pietlovic is excluded. Another goal here for Montenegro, if they can find one, would give them an outstanding chance, but that's an outstanding save instead by Slobodan Soro in the Serbian goal.
Interesting to see his reaction compared to that of Stepanovic at the other end, who's all about aggression and almost like the American USA goalkeeper, who loves to give some chat to his teammates, trying to urge them on and to give them a little bit more of an incentive. But this is patient play from Montenegro. They know exactly what they want to do here. Not prepared to rush the game. They want to dictate the tempo. None of the urgency that we saw from them early on.
They draw the foul. Aleksic complaining.
It's a penalty foul as well. Exclusion with a substitution. So Aleksic is now out of this altogether.
And Serbia having something of a meltdown. His third major foul. And it gives Montenegro a chance from the 5-meter line to extend their lead to 11-8 if they can convert here. It would be the first time they had a three-goal advantage in this game. Ivovic. And he's got it. First goal of the final quarter. Is three goals going to be enough, Tony?
I would have thought it is, given that Serbia have got
three plays.
So little backup now to call upon.
One of the Montenegrin players couldn't even watch. It was that tight, that worry, but it's gone in.
Ivovic, one of those who's got a tremendous scoring record during these Olympic Games. He managed one in the semi-final against Spain, but he's managed three in a game on three occasions, including three against Serbia in that one that finished 11-all. But don't forget that in that one it was Montenegro who trailed 11-9 but fought back, equalising with just 51 seconds left. But they've got to dig deep now, Serbia, if they're to try and rescue this.
We're off and running again. Can Serbia take advantage here? Yes, they can. Good, strong left-handed shot by Filipovic. Pulls Serbia back into it. Just two goals behind now. Skip shot was good and true. Filipovic, who plays in Italy. Target.
Yeah, he's got a great record at these Olympics. Three against Australia. His semi-final, he scored against Romania. I think he scored against just about everybody. He's got goals in there in every single one. Four against Great Britain when His Royal Highness Prince William watched. Great Britain surprisingly leading that one for a time.
Great chance here for Montenegro, and it's saved again by Soro. The two worried expressions there, and the faces of the Montenegro players. And a Serbian goal now would really put this game in the balance, but it's been a turnover foul. Lukovic penalised. Another turnover foul. Accurate ball by the goalkeeper to pick out Mitrovic. Serbia running out of options now with so many of their players excluded. Big save, push back in though, great push shot. Serbia are not finished yet. Goal is by Nikic. We're back to just a one goal advantage.
Great play by Nikic. Featured in 2004, missed out altogether 4 years ago, and look how the coach here, Ljubovicic, is urging his team on. Head coach for the last 6 years, he played for Partizan for a time.
So this one back in the balance now. Remember, Montenegro had a three-goal advantage at one stage of this last quarter. Oh, and Montenegro unlucky there, the crossbar coming to the aid of Serbia. Shot ricochets to safety after Alexander Ivovic. Another skip shot. Can Serbia find an equaliser with 4 minutes to go? Passes a wayward one. Nikic with the turnover foul. Jokic on two major fouls.
Wonder if Udovicic can lift Serbia. He has been their star performer in recent times, twice a medalist at the Olympic Games with both Serbia and Serbia-Montenegro. Missed a lot of the build-up because of injury, but if he is fit now and he's in the pool and he can make a contribution, you can be sure that he will have an influence. That's the number four for Serbia. Here he is.
From the University of Belgrade.
And they've had to hand the possession back to Montenegro. It's just adds to Ljubovicic's irritation.
Looks like an exclusion foul with a substitution. Vietlovic is disappearing now. Well, they are running out of players. Serbia struggling.
Good save.
Outstanding save. Vukovic, run outside the 5 metre line, just waiting for that shot clock to move further towards zero, towards 30 rather. No goal. Getting pretty tight now, just 2.5 minutes left. Jetlovic out for the pull for the remainder. The equaliser is denied there, again by a shot against the crossbar.
Filipovic, was it, the left-hander? Can't exactly catch the cap numbers yet, but it's his.
Mandic. It's Mandic who had the shot. And smacked against the crossbar.
Mitrovic out in the water.
Opportunity knocks here for Montenegro, and again against the crossbar.
That's a thrilling conclusion. They're both getting increasingly desperate now.
Two players out, one from either side. Dvojkovic out for Montenegro. Serbia press for an equalising goal. It's going to be now or never. A little chip and a lob goal. And they're level. Filipovic. Whoa.
It's a fantastic find back. Fantastic recovery, because it looked as though Montenegro were comfortably in charge. But when they needed a spark and they needed something special, we talked about Udovicic, the number four, who's been making things happen. And what a finish that by Filipovic with a lob.
11. And
that is coolness under pressure, no doubt about that.
11 all, just as it was when these two teams met at the group stage. The difference is that was at the end of the match. We still have 1:39 left on the clock.
Well, it really could go either way now, but let's not forget that Serbia have had so many players ruled out of this, and if he's not careful, Udovicic will be following them out. He's been ushered back. Aleksic out, Rajan out, Jokic out, Pijetvilic out. Good to be a coach, eh?
Talk about in the balance. Just a bit. 11 all. Most likely outcome, perhaps. Overtime. Both teams will have at least one serious attempt. At least one serious attempt to have a shot on goal because of the stop clock.
Oh, it's a steal. Can they counter now quickly? That's what the coach wants them to do. Urging everybody forward.
I think he'd like to get in the water with them, wouldn't he?
We might have the chance if they emerge with the bronze medal. Not before.
Milenovic. And they've got it with 55 seconds left on the clock. Milenovic on target. Oh, dear. They've come from absolutely nowhere and have their noses in front.
What a response. Magnificent response by Serbia, given that they trailed and they fell further behind. But they've turned it around in dramatic fashion, given that so many of this squad are unavailable to the coach. Great finish by Udovicic, who we marked out earlier as being one who might make a contribution.
55 left. It means that Montenegro will have an opportunity. Look at their coach. Two coaches going through absolute hell at the moment.
Udovicic has been dismissed as well.
Yeah, he's gone.
Red card, he had his warning earlier on.
So the assistant coach will have to fill in here for Serbia, who have only 44 seconds to hang on. Montenegro have lost it.
Ooh, but it's an exclusion.
Another exclusion here against number 11, Prelenovic. It's now or never for Montenegro. They have to score. They just have to score. Serbia defending for all they're worth. 20 seconds left. Clock runs down. Oh, what a big save! A bronze medal save by the goalkeeper, Sorrow. And it's Sorrow for Montenegro.
Fantastic. Absolutely brilliant. Oh, another red card. Who's gone this time? Is it... Well, it's the assistant coach who's gone now. They've got three assistants on the bench. The coach has been dismissed. And now the first of the three additional assistants, or the additional coaches that Serbia have got.
Talk about a family at war. And another red card being shown. Udovicic is out. Coach out, assistant coach out.
Well, the referee's got to take charge here, firmly take charge and halt things. It's the second timeout that has been taken. And who is responsible? Who is doing the coaching now? Because the arguments are continuing. A moment of contemplation, a little bit of calm. You can understand the frustration and you can understand the anxiety because, as you mentioned, Gary, it's now or never.
Was that big save going to be enough to earn Serbia the bronze medal?
I think there might even be a representative of FINA who's down there trying to sort things out. You see there on the far left side of the picture that we saw, and the discussion is going on, and another red card is being flourished here. Udovicic excluded with a substitution, and who else is going to go?
Red card being shown to somebody in the pool.
It's Nikola Janovic. Is he the only one, or is there more? May well be, but we saw that, didn't we, earlier? Was it Udovic?
Udovic is gone. He has to go. We have 16 seconds left of this highly charged bronze medal match from the men's water polo. Teams might be running out of players shortly.
There's going to be one chance, just one chance for Montenegro to try and get an equaliser in normal time. And if they do, they're going to be into overtime. Just wonder if this disruption has helped or hindered. See the fouls, they sometimes almost break safe. Now hang on, we'll have to stop and start again.
Another Serbian player excluded here. So Montenegro still have a great chance. 8 seconds left on the clock. They have to score, they have to score. They've slammed it against the crossbar. They have to score again. It's against the post. They've rattled it in, but it's too late. The hooter has gone, I think. It's not going to count. Sorrow with his fist in the air, and so close for Montenegro. They couldn't come any closer without taking it into overtime. And when the ball eventually entered the goal, the hooter had gone. And incredibly, Serbia, against all odds, have taken the bronze medal.
Extraordinary finish. Really was an extraordinary finish. And Udovicic, the coach, who was shown a red card, one of his assistants was red carded. It was impossible to gauge in that last couple of minutes who should have been in the pool and who should have been out. Real disappointment for Petrovic, who's had a couple of years now in charge of Montenegro. But sorrow to the rescue on more than one occasion. And he had a bit of luck at the end there with the ball hitting both posts.
The result of the bronze medal match. What a story here. Montenegro 11, but Serbia win it with 12 goals. How on earth did that happen?
It was brilliant to watch, it really was.
They had a 3-goal lead at one stage in the last period. How they threw that away. Do you think they were just too defensive in that moment when they were 3 goals up and thought they had the match all sewn up?
Well, there was a period where they seemed to lose a bit of momentum. They still had possession of the ball, but the tempo suddenly dropped, and maybe that was what Montenegro wanted. or didn't want to enable Serbia to try and get back into it. But equally, when you look at Serbia, the number of exclusions with substitutions that they had, and there was that flurry of red cards, Rajan was out of the game altogether, clearly for something that he'd said after he'd been excluded. Udovicic, the coach, is then told to leave the pool side. Everything was counting against Serbia, but what resolve and what determination to come back in the way that they did.
Bronze medalist 4 years ago in Beijing, and bronze medalists again here in London 2012. It was an extraordinary end to the match, with so many players excluded, 3-goal deficit to make up. They shrugged aside their disappointment and claim very well-deserved bronze again. They'll come again, no doubt, in 4 years' time in Rio. There'll be a match, I'm sure, for the elite water polo playing nations, the Olympics. Serbia, Montenegro in the medals 8 years ago when they took silver, bronze 4 years ago. He needs to go and sit in a quiet room, in a darkened room, I think.
His team never does it the easy way. World Championships in Rome, when they defeated Spain to take the gold medal, it went to a penalty shootout on that occasion after it finished a 6-6 at the end of normal time, at the end of the fourth quarter.
So we stand by for the gold medal match. People still talking about that incredible ending to the bronze medal game. Let's hope the gold medal match is as exciting.